everyone, welcome to our program Doctor, and today I'm going to discuss about rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis is an autoimmune disorder that results in a chronic systemic inflammatory disorder that may affect many tissues and organs, but principally attacks flexible joints, that is synovial joints. It can be a painful condition if not adequately treated, which can lead to substantial loss of functioning and mobility. The process involves an inflammatory response of the capsule around the joints, especially synovium, secondary to swelling of synovial cells, excess synovial fluid, and the development of fibrous tissue in the synovium, that is pannus formation. Next, coming to the signs and symptoms. Rheumatoid arthritis mainly affects joints, but it can also affect other organs in 15 to 25% of the cases. So coming to the involvement of joints in rheumatoid arthritis. Arthritis of joints involves inflammation of the synovial membrane. Joints become swollen, tender and warm, and stiffness, particularly early in the morning on waking, and stiffness of joints limits the movement. And with time, multiple joints are affected. That is called polyarthritis. Most commonly involved are small joints of hands, feet, and cervical spine. But larger joints like the shoulder joint and knee joint can also be involved. Synovitis can lead to tethering of tissue with loss of movement and erosion of the joint surface, causing deformity and loss of function. In the worst case, joints are known as arthritis mutilans due to the mutilating nature of the deformities. Next one is involvement of skin. The rheumatoid nodule, which is sometimes cutaneous, is the diagnostic feature of the rheumatoid arthritis. The nodule has a central area of fibrinoid necrosis, and that may be fissured, and which corresponds to the fibrin-rich necrotic material which is found in and around an affected synovial space. The typical rheumatoid nodule may be few millimeters to few centimeters in diameter, and which is usually found over bony prominences such as the olecranon and calcaneus tuberosity and the metacarpophalangeal joints. Coming to the involvement of lungs. Fibrosis of lungs and pleural effusion are associated with rheumatoid arthritis. And another complication of rheumatoid arthritis is rheumatoid lung disease. And in America, 1/4 of the people who suffers with rheumatoid arthritis may develop rheumatoid lung disease. Coming to the involvement of kidneys. Renal amyloidosis occurs as a consequence of chronic inflammation in case of this rheumatoid arthritis, and this may affect renal glomeruli. Treatment with penicillamine or gold salts are recognized causes of the membranous nephropathy. Next, involvement of heart and blood vessels. People with rheumatoid arthritis are more prone to atherosclerosis and also high risk of myocardial infarction and stroke, and other complications are pericarditis and left ventricular failure. Other complications in rheumatoid arthritis: ocular lesions, more common indirect effect of keratoconjunctivitis sicca, which is a dryness of eyes and dryness of mouth caused by lymphocyte infiltration of lacrimal and salivary glands. When severe dryness of the cornea can lead to keratitis and loss of vision. Next one is hepatic lesions. Rarely, rheumatoid arthritis can cause hepatitis. Hematological lesions. Sometimes rheumatoid arthritis can cause warm autoimmune hemolytic anemia. Neurological causes. Peripheral neuropathy and mononeuritis multiplex can occur. The most common problem is carpal tunnel syndrome, caused by the compression of the median nerve by swelling around the wrist. Constitutional symptoms. which include low grade fever, fatigue, morning stiffness, loss of appetite and loss of weight are the common manifestations. Causes of rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis is a form of autoimmunity, but the causes are still not completely known. It is a systemic disorder mainly affecting synovial tissues. Half of the risk for rheumatoid arthritis is genetic, and family history is the main risk factor for this infection. A genetic link with HLA-DR4 and related allotypes of MHC class 2 and T-cell associated protein PTPN22. And these are responsible for the rheumatoid arthritis. Coming to the diagnosis, X-rays, MRI, that is magnetic resonance imaging, and ultrasound are also used. Presence of rheumatoid factor in the blood, that is RF factor, indicates rheumatoid arthritis positive. Rheumatoid factor is a non-specific antibody, but a negative rheumatoid factor does not rule out the rheumatoid arthritis, and this type of rheumatoid arthritis is called seronegative rheumatoid arthritis, which can see in 15% of cases. Next, coming to the differential diagnosis, several other medical conditions can resemble this rheumatoid arthritis. They should be distinguished from it at the time of the diagnosis. For example, crystal induced arthritis, these are gout and pseudogout, osteoarthritis, systemic lupus erythematosus, psoriatic arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, Lyme disease, and also hepatitis C, etc. These are all differential diagnosis. Coming to the treatment, anti-inflammatory agents, NSAIDs reduce both pain and stiffness in those people who suffer with rheumatoid arthritis. Alternatively, we can use COX-2 inhibitors, example celecoxib, and also we can use glucocorticoids. Surgery. In early phases of the disease, an open synovectomy can be performed. It consists of the removal of the affected synovia and prevents quick destruction of the affected joints. Severely affected joints may require joint replacement surgery, such as knee replacement. So, rheumatoid arthritis is an autoimmune disease which is predominantly seen in females. But the causes of this disease is not completely known. However, family history is the risk factor for this disease. I hope you learned something about rheumatoid arthritis today. Thanks for watching. See you with another topic.